while you nurture their mind and their body. And therefore this amana that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon us, my dear brothers and sisters, this ability to rationalize and to use our body can be used like al-an'am. I want you to think of some of the words Allah uses in the Quran. One of the words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He uses, He talks about fahisha. When a person makes a sin, it is fahsha wal-munkar. The Imam always reads it in for us at the end of our khutbah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Allah orders you to good. وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ and forbid you fahsha. The word fahsha comes from the same word that means wahsh, wild beast. In Arabic, when an animal is in the pasture, a lion roaming, no one to control it, you call it wahsh. هُوَ مُتَوَحِّشْ. And when a human being's soul has become so devious that they act in a beastly manner, you say, كَأَنَّهُ تَوَحَّشْ. That man, he's acting like an animal. فَاحِشَ. Sin, my dear brothers and sisters, that strips your soul of iman. See, your iman is attached to your soul. It's not attached to your body. Wallahi, you can stand and you can move your body up and down all your life. But if your soul is not in the ruku' and in the sujood and in the qiyam and in the Qur'an, it is just exercise. There's no niyyah, there's no intent, there's no nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tells us in the Qur'an, and we conclude with this before we ask for the adhan. He tells us that there are people, lahum أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا. Some people, we have given them eyes, but they don't see. وَآذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. And ears, they don't hear with. وَقُلُوبٌ or أَفْئِدَةٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا. And hearts, they don't understand with. How does Allah describe this person? Someone who sees but doesn't see. Hears but doesn't hear, has a heart and an intellect and a rational but doesn't think correctly. What is that example? أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ. They are like equals, partners, twins of the animals that run. بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلْ. Actually they are worse. Because the animal is not responsible. It doesn't know. But you know. You understand. You know al-halal, and you know al-haram, and you know the limits. You know the good, and you know the bad. You know the easy, and you know the difficult. You know what is merciful, and what is oppressive. كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ شَهِيدًا. It's enough for you on the Day of Judgment, Allah will say, to witness against yourself. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with the soul that obeys Allah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the soul that relishes and rejoices in the disobedience of Allah azza wa jal. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. After I stand on the minbar, insha'Allah, we will talk about the tazkiyah, the purification of our hearts and soul. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وبعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ثم أما بعد. Always we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and send our greetings upon the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We remind one another of the taqwa of Allah azza wa jal and to be upon the consciousness that He is deserving of us. We were talking about al-insan, the human being, and we said that we are three parts. The most important part of you, my dear brother and sister in Islam, is your ruh, your nafs, your soul. followed by your rationale and intellect and mind, and third and finally is your badan, your physical being. And we said that when the soul is corrupt, the other two corrupt. There is no helping it. There is no opportunity to salvage them unless you salvage the soul. And the seat of the soul, the Imams of Ahl Sunnah, they say, the word ruh and the word nafs, it is what sits to sadr. And therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. And Musa alayhi salam, he asks Allah, رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي. The sadr is the seat of the heart. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, in the body, there's a place, there's a part of your body, إِذَا صَلُحَتْ, if it is good, if it is pure, if it is clean, if it is healthy, صَلُحَ الْبَدَنُ كُلُّ, the rest of your being, everything of who you are and what you stand for, naturally follows into acceptability and healthiness. And that place is the heart. And whenever the Imams spoke about the soul, they would call it tazkiyatul nufus aw tathhirul qulub, purifying your soul or cleansing your heart. Tazkiyah is zakah. The word zakah, you clean your money because you share it with others. You want to make it perfect. You don't want that you have taken something and benefited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's decree for you, and that you leave others suffering without aiding them. In the same way, my dear brothers and sisters, the tazkiyah of the soul begins with looking into yourself in how you as a human being could be of benefit to others. You see, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the basis of his life, the basis of his message, the whole spirit of his call, the basis of our submission in tawheed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the way we honor Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most after recognizing him is being dutiful to those who we live amongst. And you see, the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he lists out the major sins in Islam as being things that injure others. Murder, adultery, undutifulness, unkindness to your parents. Things that are not just you are doing it wrong, but you have injured and harmed others. How do we purify our heart and perfect our soul? The ulama of al-tazkiyah, they speak of different paths and different opportunities that a person can shine their heart so it is like a mirror, so bright that it reflects the nur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places it. Everything in our life begins with tawheed. And you and I, we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we may not have been taught primarily the focus of our tawheed. The tawheed that Allah accepts from you, my dear brothers and sisters, is built on 7 principles. The first of them is al-ilm, knowledge of Allah, ma'rifa billah, fa'alam annahu la ilaha illallah. Who is your Lord? Know him. How many of the names of Allah do you know and apply in your life in how you deal with others? Allah labels himself Ar-Rahman, the merciful to us, to remind us to be merciful to others. Laysa minna, he cannot be from us who does not honor the elder and show mercy to the younger. Ar-Rahimuna yarhamuhum Ar-Rahman, the merciful, Allah the most merciful, shall show them mercy. Al-ilm, you begin with knowing Allah. And that knowledge has to raise and rise to a level of yaqeen. That knowledge has to lead you to be certain of Allah. And one of the things we make mistakes with in our community is that we know, but we don't know enough to be certain. Or we know and don't question. And Allah asks you to question and wants you to ask. And Ibrahim alayhi salam asks Allah, Rabbi arini kayfa tuhyi al-mawta. My Lord, how will the dead come to life? Show me, arini with my own eyes. Musa, who speaks with Allah, he asks, Rabbi arini anzur ilayk. Allow me to see you with my eyes. Questions that need answers. And it's only through answers that certainty is met. And Allah wants you to learn and then be certain. علم اليقين, as if you have seen Allah. Haritha, the Sahabi of the Prophet ﷺ, the Prophet says to him, كيف حالك? How are you, Haritha? He says, أصبحت مؤمنا يا رسول الله. I am a believer today. And the Prophet ﷺ says, everything that a person says has to have proof. How do you prove this statement? How do you know you have iman? He says, إِذَا عَبَدْتَ اللَّهَ كَأَنِّي أَرَاهُ. When I stand in my salah, it's as if Allah is in front of me.